Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 23rd of June. India reports 40 cases of Delta Plus, says new COVID variant is a concern. Investigations underway as bomb blast kills at least 4, wounds 14 in Pakistan. And UN envoy issues warning as Taliban launches offensive in Afghanistan. And now for all the details. At a time when India is witnessing a dip in active COVID-19 cases, there are over 40 cases in the country of the new Delta Plus strain, which has been tagged as a variant of concern by the government. India's health ministry also said that India is among the 9 countries where the Delta Plus variant has been detected.
India on Tuesday declared a new coronavirus variant identified locally as Delta Plus to be of concern. Over 40 of new Delta Plus strain cases have been detected in 4 states, Maharashtra, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Delta Plus is presumed to descend from the B.1.617.2 variant or Delta in the WHO naming system. Delta Plus carries an additional mutation K.417N that has been associated with antibody escape in other variants. India's health ministry said Delta Plus showed increased transmissibility and advised the authorities to strictly enforce the COVID-19 protocols and intensified containment measures in the districts where the variant has been found. In Western Maharashtra state, 21 cases of the Delta Plus variant have been reported, and authorities said it is monitoring the situation.
We have given instructions to all my subordinate officers that the index cases of these Delta Plus variant should be monitored very closely.
Meanwhile, as the new phase of universalization of COVID-19 vaccination commenced from Monday, in a landmark achievement, 8.8 million vaccine doses were administered on the first day of the new phase beginning June 21. This is the highest single-day number of jabs in the world. However, experts doubt it could maintain the pace. The effort has so far covered about 5.5% of the 950 million people eligible, even though India is the world's largest vaccine producer. India reported on Wednesday 50,848 new coronavirus infections over the past 24 hours, Health Ministry data show. The South Asian nation's total infections now stand at 30.03 million.
Exercising its right to reply following Pakistan's remarks on the Kashmir issue at UN in Geneva, India on Tuesday said Pakistan should be held accountable for aiding and abetting terrorism as it continues to provide pensions to dreaded unlisted terrorists and host them on its territory as its state policy.
Pakistan should be held accountable for aiding and abetting terrorism as it continues to provide pensions to dreaded enlisted terrorists and host them on its territory as its state policy, India said on Tuesday. Exercising India's right to reply following Pakistan's remarks at the 47th session of the United Nations Human Rights Council, New Delhi highlighted the systematic persecution of minorities in Pakistan through draconian blasphemy laws, forced conversions and marriages and extrajudicial killings. India also condemned the attack and vandalization of ancient sites of religious minorities in Pakistan.
The scourge of terrorism is the gravest violation of human rights and must be dealt with in strongest terms in all its forms and manifestations. Pakistan, as its state policy, continues to provide pensions to dreaded enlisted terrorists and host them on its territory. It is high time that Pakistan is held accountable for aiding and abetting terrorism.
India's remarks came after Khalil Hashmi, Pakistan's diplomat to the UN in Geneva, tried to raise Kashmir's issue at the interactive dialogue on the annual report of the High Commissioner. Meanwhile, Pakistan's fate at the Financial Action Task Force or FATF is under the scanner this week, as the Global Terror Financing Watchdog is holding its plenary session beginning Monday and the outcome will be announced on June 25. Decision will be made on whether Islamabad stays on the grey list or not. Pakistan was put on the grey list by the Paris-based FATF in June 2018 and the country has been struggling to come out of it for non-compliant with anti-money laundering and terrorist financing regulations by FATF.
In news from Pakistan, a bomb attack in a residential area of Pakistan's eastern city of Lahore killed 4 people on Wednesday, including a child, and wounded 14, police said. But there was no immediate claim of responsibility. Those wounded by a powerful blast in a residential area included local people and some police officers who were manning a checkpoint set up next to the house of Hafiz Saeed, the founder of Islamist militant group Lashkar-e-Taiba. Shrapnel and shattered glass could still be seen around the blast site around midday. Provincial Police Chief Inam Ghani said the police were investigating whether the explosives had been detonated remotely or by a suicide bomber. Saeed, who now runs a LET-linked charity, Jamaat-ud-Dawah, was sentenced in November to 10 years imprisonment after being found guilty of 2 charges of financing terrorism.
I'm duty karta hu yahan pe KKT mein to jab duty pe aaye hain abhi main andar gaya hu to ekdam se awaaz aayi zor ki puri building hil gayi hai to humne kaha pata nahi kya hua achanak bahar nikle dekha to pata chala ji blast ho gaya yahan pe to ekdam se itna khauf tari ho gaya yahan pe sari duniya jo hai bahar nikla gharon se ye building se sare sheeshe toot gaye hain to ghar tabah ho gaye hain kuch to bahut nuksan hua hai.
Moving on, Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has blamed he has doubts over Pakistan PM Imran Khan's plans with regard to the illegally occupied region. He said Imran Khan's PTI party wants to influence voting in the polls in July and blamed it aims to further divide the region, but he won't let it happen. Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has said he has apprehensions over Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan's plans with regard to the illegally occupied region, as he accused Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI party of trying to ignite tensions ahead of election in July. Speaking to reporters, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, a senior leader of Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz Party, remarked that PTI wants to influence voting in the upcoming election and aims to make Pakistan-administered Kashmir a province or divide it into parts, but he won't let it happen.
वो आपका क्या प्रोग्राम है आजाद कश्मीर के हवाले से फ्यूचर का इसका हमें उसके खदशात हैं क्योंकि उन्होंने खुद भी कहा था इसको 3 उसमें तकसीम कर दें कोई कहते हैं कि अपनी पार्टी के लीडर कहते हैं कि जनाब अगर सुबह बन गया तो कोई बात फर्क नहीं पड़ता क्यों नहीं फर्क पड़ता.
Pakistan PM Imran Khan had announced granting provisional province status to Gilgit-Baltistan last year ahead of elections there, a move that was not received well by people in both the illegally occupied territories of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. India had also launched a strong protest against the Pakistan government, stating that Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, including Gilgit-Baltistan, are an integral part of India. In news from Afghanistan, UN Special Envoy to Afghanistan Deborah Lyons has warned that increased conflict in Afghanistan posed a risk of insecurity to many other countries. Her statement came as Taliban insurgents have captured more than 50 of 370 districts in Afghanistan since May as foreign forces continue a withdrawal from the country while peace talks have stalled.
Taliban insurgents have captured more than 50 of 370 districts in Afghanistan since May, Deborah Lyons, the UN Special Envoy to Afghanistan, said on Tuesday, warning that increased conflict posed a risk of insecurity to many other countries. Lyons told the 15-member UN Security Council that the announcement earlier this year that U.S. forces along with personnel from NATO countries will withdraw by September 11 sent a seismic tremor through Afghanistan.
But the relentless spirit of the Afghans and their incredible resilience is being severely tested, and the possible slide toward dire scenarios is undeniable. What happens in Afghanistan remains, of course, of global consequence, and the Security Council needs to be fully informed of the gravity of the present situation.
Fighting between government forces and the Taliban has surged in recent weeks, with the militants gaining control of more territory as US-led international forces continue drawdown. In the latest, suspected Taliban fighters on Wednesday fired a rocket into a hospital in eastern province of Kunar, sparking a blaze that caused extensive damage, though there was no reports of casualties, officials said.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The Supreme Court of Nepal on Tuesday annulled the cabinet reshuffle by Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli, following which a total of 20 ministers from the government have been relieved from the post. The court order stated that while the parliament is dissolved, only existing cabinet members would be continuing over their posts.
Nepal's Supreme Court on Tuesday annulled the last round of cabinet reshuffle by Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli when 12 ministers and 8 state ministers were inducted into the cabinet. The verdict stated that under special circumstances when the parliament is dissolved, it has been clearly stated that only existing cabinet members under incumbent Prime Minister would be continuing over their posts. Following the interim order, a total of 20 ministers from caretaker Prime Minister Oli's government have been relieved from their posts. A case was lodged with the Supreme Court in earlier weeks of June, challenging Oli's move. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court was on Wednesday scheduled to resume hearing writ petitions filed jointly by opposition parties against the government's move to dissolve the House of Representatives. Nepal's President Bidya Devi Bhandari, on the recommendation of Prime Minister Oli, had dissolved the lower house of the parliament earlier in May and declared to hold midterm elections on November 12 and 19.
Farmers in remote areas of India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, who were grappling with water shortage for quite some time, have now heaved a sigh of relief as they have been provided with water supply by the irrigation department through small canals. They expressed happiness and said they can now sow their crops on time. Farmers in Rajouri district of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory had been struggling for water supply for quite some time now. They took a sigh of relief after the district administration extended help 3 months ago to supply water for irrigation of their lands. Farmers who are solely dependent on agricultural lands to earn their livelihood are cultivating paddy and maize after receiving water supply from the irrigation department of Darhal block in the district.
तो पिछले एक दो दो तीन साल में इरिगेशन फ्लड कंट्रोल डिपार्टमेंट ने यहाँ पर जो हमारी ये चार पांच जो प्रोजेक्ट जो हैं वो कंप्लीट किए हैं उसका आज ये फ़ायदा है कि इन टाइम लोग जो हैं उनको पानी मिल रहा है और इन टाइम लोग अपनी फसलें वगैरह जो हैं यहाँ पर लगा रहे हैं इन दूर दराज पहाड़ी इलाका में और नतीजतन इसका फ़ायदा जो है आने वाले वक्त में लोगों को अपनी फसलों की बेहतरी से मिलेगा
उनको हमने तकरीबन हमारे 4,000 के लगभग हमारे जो सीड है वो लोगों को मिल गया है और निशारा और सुंदरबनी के एरिए में अभी सोइंग स्टार्ट है कुछ किस्मती की बात यह है कि यहाँ इस साल मॉनसून 15 दिन पहले आ गया है जिससे कि हमारे किसानों की बुआई बिल्कुल ठीक टाइम पर हो जाएगी
Residents are happy that they are getting a proper water supply for farming with the help of small canals. Department of Irrigation has provided water supply through small canals in Darhal, Thana Mandi, Kotranka and Naushera areas of Rajouri district. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.